Hi everyone, welcome y'all. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install iOS app on simulator using script. So first of all, let me connect to the Mac. So first of all, we need to create a simulator. So here, how to create a simulator. So in the previous session, I have shown you using Appium desktop UI, how to create a simulator. So let me just open Appium server, Appium desktop server, so which is already installed on my Mac. So once you click on this, it will open up Appium desktop server. So it will take few seconds of time. All right, so once you launch your Appium desktop server, so let me start the server. Click on start server. So now my Appium server is started, and then we need to go for start inspector section, start inspector session. So click on this option. Now it will open the inspector session. So here we already created, let me minimize this. So we already created some capabilities of your iOS device. If you see this particular thing, so platform is iOS, platform version is 11.4, device name, automation name, and also have given the location of my app. This is UI catalog app. So now based on this configuration, I'm just launching my simulator. So let's click on the start session. So it will launch the simulator. Once you click on the start session, it will go and launch the simulator. So let's wait for a few more seconds. Now it is starting my simulator. So once the simulator is started, then we need to start writing our script. Okay, so my simulator is ready. So once you have started your simulator and once booting is successful, then you can just minimize this Appium desktop inspector. Now this is currently we have a simulator. Now the next step is we need to open your Eclipse. So here I already opened my Eclipse. So let me just open my Eclipse application. So Eclipse is an IDE where we can write your automation code. So in our Eclipse, I'm going to create a new project. So new Java project. So right click here, new Java project. So whenever you create a new Java project, we need to give some project name. I'll say iOS. So iOS automation. I'll say some package name is iOS automation, and by default it is using Java 11. So click on finish button here, and it is asking to creating module ID. We don't require, so just click it, don't create. So now it is created a new Java project. So once it is created new Java project, the second step is we need to add required dependencies. So in the previous videos, I have shown you whatever the client jars we require. Like we need a Appium Java client jar and also Selenium client jars. So those jar files we need to associate with this particular project. So right click on this project, then go to properties and go to your Java build path. So here select the class path, then click on add external jars. So now I'm going to add required jar files. So here previously I already downloaded Java client. So which is one Java client means Appium Java client jar. And I'm attaching that jar file to your project. And after that, one more time, go to add external jars. Now I need to add Selenium jars. Let's go to Selenium Java and these two jar files, which we need to add first. And then again, go to one more time, add external jars. And then again, go to libs folder. So inside the libs folder, we have many more jars. So let me select all of them and click on open button. So apart from this jar file, we need also additional jar file, which is commons exe1.3. So this particular jar file is also required. So not this one exactly. Just if you go back under Selenium 3 itself. So here commons lang 3 package. So this is another jar which is also required. So I'm just adding that. So now I have associated required jars or client libraries to your Java project. And then click on apply and close. So now I created a new Java project, also associated some reference client libraries. So let me create a new project. So first of all, let me create a new package and I will give you some name is iOS automation package, right? So iOS automation package, then click on the finish. So here I'm going to create a new Java class. So take the new class and I'm going to give some name called example one. On this example, I'm going to show you how to install iOS app on simulator. So example one, install iOS app on simulator. Okay, so this is my example. So take this main method and then click on the finish. So now it is created a new Java class including the main method. So the first step is we need to create a desired capabilities class object. So we need to specify the desired capabilities as a prerequisite. So let me use the class called desired capabilities. And for that, I'm creating an object called, let's say DC is equal to new desired capabilities. And here I'll say nothing, just semicolon. So then we have to import this particular package, this particular class from org opening selenium.remote. Just import this package. So now using this particular DC, we need to specify the desired capabilities. So the first desired capability. So how we will know the desired capabilities? So this particular simulator we have used opened this application by using Appium client, Appium server, right? Appium desktop server. So if you just go and see the Appium desktop server, and here I have just configured the desired capability sometime back, right? So those desired capabilities we need to copy somewhere, and the same desired capabilities we have to refer here. So here I'm adding required desired capabilities of this particular UI catalog app. So the first desired capability is, let's say DC dot set capability. So that's a first method, set capability. And here we need to specify the capability and their value. So we need to pass mobile capability dot, and the first one is, I'm saying mobile capability type, sorry, mobile capability type dot, and these are all different capabilities list. So we need to select proper capabilities, required capabilities. The first capability I'm saying selecting is automation name. So automation name for iOS app is, this should be XCUI test. So this is the first capability. And similarly, I will also add a few more capabilities. Let me add. So the second capability is a platform name. Let me just remove this. When I say dot, it will give you platform name. So the platform name is a second capability. So here I'm specifying the name of the platform. So the name of the platform is iOS. And iOS. So this is my name of the platform. I is a small lowercase letter, OS is uppercase letter. And the next capability is platform. So dot, the next one is platform version, or platform name we already specified. So this time I'll say platform version. So the platform version is, I'm using iOS device which having 11.4 version. This is for our platform version. And the next capability is name of the device. So I'm just saying dot, okay, device name. I'll say device name. So the name of the device is iPhone 8 I'm using. So currently I'm just say iPhone 8. So I'll say iPhone 8. So this is my device. Okay, so with this, along with this, we need to also specify some other capability, that is app location. So how to specify the app location is, we need to have one more capability, that is app. So let me just select that one. So dot app, all right? So this is app is one of the capability. Here we need to specify the location where exactly our iOS app is present. So I have captured this iOS path earlier. So let me just copy this location. This is a location where my iOS app is present. Let me just copy from here and then I'll paste it over here. So this is a location of my app, right? So these are all required capabilities which we need to set at the before. And now we need to specify the URL. So let's say URL, this is again predefined class URL, and URL is a variable is equal to. So first of all, we specify the URL class, and URL is a variable is equal to new URL. And here we need to specify the Appium server URL. So normally Appium server URL will be HTTP. So let me write it here, HTTP, small letters, HTTP colon slash slash, and default port 127 .0.0.1 and colon, and your Appium server is currently running on the port that is 4723. So this is a port number, and slash slash wd and slash hub. So this is a Appium server running URL. So once we have specified this, now we need to also import this URL class from java.net. So once we have done this, then we have to specify the driver we have to create. So iOS driver we have to create. So the next step is iOS driver, and I'll create one driver object is equal to new iOS driver. And here I need to pass URL and along with the desired capabilities object. So the first one is URL, and the second parameter is desired capability object. So that's it, guys. So we need to import iOS driver from io.appium.java client.ios. Right, so this is our automation code. So when I run this particular script, it will go and install this particular app on my simulator. This is iOS device. So let me execute my code now. So let me run as Java application. So once you started execution, so it will go and install the app on my iOS device. So now you can see here on iOS device, it is trying to install UI catalog app. And once it is installed, it will also launch that particular app. So there we can see all the options, right? So now my script is completed. So this is how we need to just install any app, any iOS app on my simulator. Okay. So that's all for with this video, guys. So thanks for watching.